Music in the German Capitals by Joe Hines.
Hose, 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 Hose.
If you travel 500 miles across the U.S., you may pass through 4 or 5 states. If you travel 500 miles across Europe, you may pass through 4 or 5 countries. Unlike traveling in the U.S., where you'll hear almost all English and maybe a few people speaking Spanish, traveling in Europe can introduce you to dozens of dialects and languages. German is arguably the most influential language on the continent. There are only a few languages in Europe, albeit some pretty big ones, that aren't closely related to German. Portuguese, Spanish, Italian, French, Romanian, and the Slavic languages are the only ones not close to German. There's also Finland, who kind of just made up their own language unrelated to any other language. So, well, okay, real quick, let's examine Finnish. What is this? Like, seriously, what is this? The city names are even better. A lot of Finnish city names are extremely vulgar, but I'll run through a quick list of the ones that are a little less extreme. There's E, which roughly translates to a place to stay the night, Kiemenkulma, which means corner of sexual arousement, and then my personal favorite, Saran Paskanta Marasari, which means the island that Sarah defecated on. Anyways, back to more conventional languages. Everything else in Europe, including Danish, Dutch, Norwegian, Swedish, Icelandic, and even Luxembourgish, is very similar to German. There is one language that is recognized worldwide, however. It's called music. When a band or artist starts to gain some popularity, it's very common to see them tour throughout Europe. And most of these tours end up somewhere in the Germanic countries. A lot of these tours also go through the big art cities like Paris, London, Milan, and Stockholm. But over the past 25 years, the Germanic countries have attracted much more musical attention. Surprisingly, Berlin isn't a very hot destination, but Hamburg, Leipzig, and Munich are full of sound. First, let's talk about bands and artists from the three cities: Vienna, Zurich, and Berlin. Berlin has spawned very few notable bands, but is also home to Germany's most famous band, Rammstein. Zurich has even less notable bands, but is home to the popular metal band, Celtic Frost. Vienna doesn't have much to offer either, but it's home to the black metal band Summoning. Mainland Europe just doesn't have the same musical punch as Scandinavia or the British Isles. A bar is the place a true artist or band makes their name. The Beatles are well known for being formed in Liverpool, but their rise to fame has direct roots to Hamburg, Germany. As we all know, the Beatles single-handedly created the modern age of music. Even after being deported for charges of arson after the group lit a condom on fire in an alley, the group remained popular in Hamburg. Without the help of a few clubs in Hamburg, the Beatles may have never become the most popular band in history. Fast forward about 20 years and the European tour craze begins. When Joy Division released their debut in 1979, the young genre known as alternative started to gain traction. When U2 released their debut in 1980, the genre really blew up. Now, let's get into my favorite topic, the bar tours. In most cities, you can find a bar or two around the block, but in Germany, bars are everywhere. Popular concert bars in Berlin include the Junction Bar, York Schlossenschen, Schokoladen, and Hangar 49. Usually smaller bands play at these places, so let's talk about the bigger venues. Bigger bands play for bigger crowds, and a bar just can't contain an audience of more than 100 people. The Waldbrunne is one of the most unique venues I've ever seen. The structure looks like an ancient Greek amphitheater. The most famous event here was a Metallica concert in 1991. Vienna doesn't have many concert bars or even concert venues in general. What they do have is theaters, lots of them. Classical ensembles and orchestras perform daily throughout the city. Zurich has a pretty wide range of different venues, including the Hallenstadion, which holds large crowds. Smaller venues include Bogen F, Complex 457, and Papierstall.
Hey, do you think the band's gonna come on soon?
Yeah, I hope pretty soon.
Hey, can you pass me that non-alcoholic drink?
Sure can.
Thanks, dude.
You're welcome.
Some bands that have performed at these cities include the Brian Jonestown Massacre. Oasis. Mayhem. U2. Codeine. And Death Heaven.
Thank you for watching. Also, I'd like to thank Zach Kimball for not showing up to help film, but instead choosing to go over to Cassidy's house.